Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, good afternoon everyone. We are from Group 2. We will present about monitoring plan for Sporoptera litorapes on watermelon plant. And before we start our presentation today, I will introduce our member. First, my name is Farika Retama Pujarini, student number 060. And there are Fitria India Susanti, student number 056. Desi Cahyanti with student number 058, Nur Hovifa with student number 059, Pujianti with student number 062, and Erika Hutasoy with student number 064.
Number 1, the rhyme of observation. Number 2, description. Number 3, monitoring plan. Number 4, sampling technica. Number 5, conclusion.
The aim of observation: to determine the quantity of eye major pests of Sporoptera litora on watermelon plants as seen from the number of eye major threat insects per month. Description about name of pests in Sporoptera litora and host plant Citrullus lanatus. Crea caterpillars of Sporoptera litora or polypids or have a wide host range so that they have the potential to become pests in various types of food crops, vegetables, fruit, and plantation. Watermelon is an herbaceous fruit plant that grows fine. This plant originated in Africa, then developed rapidly to various countries both in tropical and subtropical areas, one of which is Indonesia. Watermelon plants are seasonal relatively fast in production because they are only up to 6 months old.
Classification of Sporoptera litora: kingdom Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, ordo Lepidoptera, family Notudea, genus Lepidoptera, spesies Sporoptera litora.
Attacking stadium. Stadium Sporoptera litora did only damage watermelon plants, especially the leaf, was the larvae. The attack of instar 1 and instar 2 larvae causes the watermelon leaf to appear partially or completely white. Instar 3 and instar 4 larvae usually destroy young leaf that have not fully appeared and can be found 1 until 3 larvae per leaf. Life cycle. The life cycle range from 30 until 60 days. The egg stage take 2 until 4 days. Larvae consisting of 6 instar are 20 until 46 days, while the pupa stage range from 8 until 11 days. First instar larvae of Sporoptera litora usually live in group around the place where the egg hatches. Next, attack symptom. The young larvae in star 1 until 3 damage the leaf by leaving trends on the upper transparent epidermis and leaf bones. Unlike the case with the 4 until 6 in star, the symptom of attack on the leaf then leaf transparent of remnants of the epidermis on the top and the leaf bones, but from large leaf holes.
Okay, now we talk about the monitoring plan. The monitoring will be held in experimental garden of the Faculty of Agriculture, UPN Veteran Yogyakarta, located in Wedomartani, Blank, Sleman, Yogyakarta. The monitoring we choose for 36 days. The monitoring will do once in 3 days because the pheromones are volatile. So we will do 12 times of the observation. And monitoring interval that we choose from 2 weeks after plant until 7 weeks after plant.
Okay, this is a sampling technique. We use pheromone trap. The trap use pheromone so that male imago enter into the trap. The pheromones is placed into a plastic bag or tube, then hung in bucket near the hole in the lid of this bucket trap and attached to a bamboo pole.
Okay, In this slide, you can see we use simple random sampling. The reason we use this technique sampling because the Spodoptera litora imago spread over the land. And in our picture, you can see there are 15 beds and trap pheromones are placed at 6 points. And the conclusion from our presentation is the Spodoptera litora pest on watermelon plants is very detrimental. Therefore, it's necessary to monitor the number of pests in the field. Monitoring was carried out using a pheromone trap with the same random sampling method. And thank you for attention. And wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.